Noted that Mr. Robertson couldn't purchase enough wine gums for his calorific outtake of that speech from a sole check on check duty, but nevertheless, it's a useful, discreet measure, Mr. Speaker. As Associate Minister of Climate Change, or for climate change issues, I'd like to build on what my colleague, Mr. Foss, has said in relation to part two of this bill, the Climate Change Response Unit Restriction Amendment. And I'd like to emphasise the following points to the House. This bill will act to maintain the integrity of the Emissions Trading Scheme, which is the government's primary policy tool to address climate change. An unintended consequence has occurred in the operation of the Emissions Trading Scheme. It allows particular participants opportunities to arbitrage New Zealand's units against cheaper international units. This is referred to as re-registration arbitrage. Post-1989 foresters are voluntary participants in the Emissions Trading Scheme. They are able to participate in the scheme at their discretion. Re-registration arbitrage occurs when these foresters register in and then deregister from the Emissions Trading Scheme multiple times. At registration, a post-1989 forestry participant receives New Zealand units and may surrender any emission unit when they deregister. This allows foresters to use the registration process to profit from the price difference between domestic and cheaper international units. It was never Parliament's intent for this to occur. If this unintended consequence is left unchecked, it could create significant reputational and integrity risks for the emissions trading scheme. This arbitrage activity also creates fiscal costs to the Crown. The bill ensures these risks are prevented. The bill improves the integrity of the scheme by removing the opportunity to gain from the interplay of the price difference between domestic and international units and certain design features of forestry participation. To do this, the bill will ensure that post-1989 foresters surrender New Zealand units when deregistering from the emissions trading scheme. This will stop this arbitrage activity, as there is no longer an opportunity to use the deregistration process to gain from the unit price difference. It will bring forestry into line with other emissions trading scheme participants. This bill will, of course, also permanently remove check duty, which has become an inefficient and distortionary mode of tax, and temporarily remove anti-dumping duties on imported residential building materials to increase competition, lift sector productivity and reduce the cost of residential construction. Mr. Speaker, I commend the bill to the House.
I call Moana Mackie.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Why does the National Party hate the forestry sector?
I don't know. Why